Hey, Chris Menard here. If you're an Excel user, you should know how to use the date function. I'm going to run through two examples. Let's dive in right now. Example number one is I've got this spreadsheet, and over here is month, day, and year running across. Well, I need to combine them in the date field. So that is going to be equals date. Notice there's three arguments, and they go year, month, and date. The year is cell D2. Comma, the month is cell B2, comma, and for me, the day is cell C2, August 15th, 2023, autofill that down, and I am good to go. Example number two with the date function. I just made this up. I threw a date in cell H1. I want to figure out 65 years from that date. Well, you can't just go H1 plus H2. That is clearly the wrong answer in cell H3. I'm going to delete that. We're going to use the date function for that. Same steps. I'm going to take the year in cell H1, and I'm going to add to it 65 years because I'm on the first argument where it is the years. Comma. Now here's the month, H1, and then the last argument is the day. Helps if I can type, is still cell H1. Perfect. There's your Excel function right there. There's my formula bar. I took the year and I added 65 years, and I do have 2089. Just to test this, I'm going to change that to 1 year. Perfect. 2 years. There you go. I would do the exact same if I wanted X number of months or X number of days. I would do the same that I did with the year. Thank you for your time. Feel free to subscribe. My Excel online training course is available along with my Teams and Copilot. Have a great day.